Yeah, I'm working on an ebook right now, which is going to cover the first 15 months of the time that I began writing for a living. There are a lot of people who, through my blog or you know other ways that I've run into writers, have been really curious about how I make a living as a writer, and I would really like to share that with people because it's still possible. I mean, I think a lot of people look at it maybe stuck in the more traditional, the traditional methods of making money as a writer, you know, freelancing, newspaper writing, magazine writing. But there are a lot of really sort of outside of the box ideas and ways that you can make a living as a writer these days. And so I'm really excited about that. Plus, that those first 15 months were difficult and they were challenging for us because we didn't really have any guaranteed income, and so it was a difficult transition. But you know, looking back on it, God was very gracious to us and really walked us through the whole situation. So I'm excited to tell that story and to sort of share what I've learned from it. So that's an ebook that I'm writing, and it will probably be, I'm hoping to have it out sometime in March this year. Oh,
that's great. Is it sort of memoir meets how-to kind of?
Yeah,
thing?
That's my goal. Each chapter will be just sort of a short profile on what that month was like for us, what we were going through. At the end of each chapter, I'm going to detail the different projects I was working on, how much I was making on each of those, you know, how I got those, where they came from, and then also maybe a couple of just thoughts or hints or you know things to think about as a writer that might open up some new ideas. The other thing I'm really excited about is that I've got some other writers contributing to the project. So I don't know if I'm going to start naming them because I'll probably forget someone, but Ken Mueller, Andy Cumbo, Jen Lutweiler, Kristen Tennant, Jason Boyette, Brian Lane, Tyler Stanton, Stacey Barton, a lot of writers have agreed, and these are folks who make a living or make money as writers. So they're each going to include, you know, a short essay on what life has been like for them in that regard. What I've found is it's very difficult to get a traditionally published contract. Two of my books have been traditionally published that I've co-written. So I'm not anti-traditionally published. But I've found a lot of flexibility. Some of the books that I've co-written, we've decided to self-publish, and it's worked out really well in that the people have a decent platform, and they have control over their book. They can do with it what they want. They make a lot more per book sale. So there's a lot of different aspects to it and a lot of different things to think about. But I really encourage writers these days to really think about self-publishing, to think about digital publishing. There's just a lot of different options out there these days. But there's definitely a movement towards offering the book at a reduced price or even for free, especially an ebook, just in order to build an audience, to build a platform. And if the book has some value to it and you give it away, you know, people really appreciate that, and they hang around to see what else you're up to. And so that's another option these days that a lot of people are doing, you know, is creating ebooks and then just basically giving them away for free, which is something I've been toying around with and something I'd like to do, you know, in the next year or so.
Great. Thank you so much, Shawn.
Yeah, nice to meet you, Lisa.
I really appreciate it. So I'll check back with you maybe in a couple months, and once your book starts coming out, and good luck.
Yeah, thanks.
I'll talk to you soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye.